So today we'll learn how to calculate nth order derivative. Okay, so calculating nth order derivative. Okay, so first of all we'll find the nth differential coefficient of x to power m or x raised to power m. So nth differential of x raised to the power m first. So let us say y is equal to x raised to the power m. So what will be its first differential? Y1 or dy over dx? It would be mx my x raised to the power m minus 1. Now next, what will be y2? It would be m minus 1 x raised to the power m minus 2. Now y3, it would be m minus 2, m minus 3, x raised to the power m minus 3, and so on. Okay, so what would be its nth term? Yn would be equal to m minus 2, m minus 3, so on, m minus n, and last term would be m minus n plus 1, x raised to the power m minus n. Now, if m is equal to n, or say n equal to m, okay. Now putting n at the place of m, so what we will obtain? Putting m at the place of n, so we will obtain m, sorry, here it is missing, m minus 1. So, minus 1, m minus 2, m minus 3, m minus m plus 1, x raised to the power 0. So it would be m factorial. So d over dx of x raised to the power m times would be this, m factorial. You could write this as well, m factorial. Now what would be the second thing? Second part, the nth differential coefficient of ax plus b raised to power n. So ax plus b raised to power m, here m should be greater than n. Okay, so we are doing calculation for this. So y is equal to ax plus b raised to power m, then y1 would be m ax plus b raised to power m minus 1, y2 would be m minus 1 ax plus b, here something missing, a from x, here again a into a, that will be a square, m minus 1 ax plus b raised to the power m minus 2 a square. Now y3, m minus 1 m minus 2 ax plus b raised to the power m minus 3 into a square. Okay, so here we can generalize this. Here we can generalize this this equation. So yn would be equal to m minus 1 minus 2, so on, m minus n plus 1, and here ax plus b raised to the power m minus n a raised to power n. So again putting the value n equal to m, so replacing n by m, will obtain ym is equal to m minus 1 m minus 2 m minus 3 m minus n m plus 1. Okay, and here ax plus b raised to the power 0 am. So it would be equal to m factorial a raised to the power m. So ym or dm y over dxm would be equal to this. Okay, now next, third equation, nth differential of 1 upon ax plus b. Here this term should not be 0. Okay, so what we can write, this y is equal to ax plus b raised to the power minus 1. Now differentiating, first y1 minus 1 ax plus b raised to the power minus 2. Okay, now y2 would be equal to minus 1 minus 2 ax plus b raised to the power minus 3. Okay, and a square. Now y3 minus 1 minus 2 minus 3 ax plus b raised to power minus 4 a3. Okay, so here we could find some pattern. This would be equal to, the generalized form would be yn is equal to minus 1 raised to the power n. Here we can see that it is 3 factorial, it is 2 factorial, it is 1 factorial. Okay, so n factorial ax plus b raised to the power minus n plus 1, minus n plus 1 a raised to the power n. So yn is equal to minus 1 raised to the power n, n factorial an upon ax plus b raised to the power n plus 1. So this is the n differential. Now putting the same values, replacing n by m, and we get its m derivative, but is not required here. Now next, moving on, fourth. Another differential of logarithm ax plus b. So y is equal to log ax plus b. Now y1 would be 1 upon ax plus b. Now further, it would be same as this equation. Here we can see that. Okay, so ax plus b raised to power minus 1. Now y2 is equal to minus 1 ax plus b a. Now y3 is equal to minus 1 minus 2 ax plus b raised to power minus 3 a square a. Okay, and same for the moving on. Here we have missed something, I think, so that it should be a. Yeah, a square a cube. So generalized equation would be yn equal to minus 1 raised to the power n minus 1 n minus 1 factorial ax plus b raised to the power would be minus n. Okay, and a raised to the power n. So it would be like this, ax plus b raised to the power n, and another derivative would be as follows. Now the next equation, y is equal to a raised to the power mx. So doing the same thing, y1 would be equal to m a power mx log a, and doing this we will obtain yn is equal to m raised power n a raised power mx log a raised power n. So this would be the nth derivative. Same y is equal to e raised power mx, and it would be yn equal to m raised power n e raised power mx.